It's that time of year you've all been looking forward to. I'd like to introduce you to my new website, where you'll have access to incredible content about online business, premium apps, and anything else related to the computer world. To sign up for the newsletter, go to www.officialaboypappy.com and click the subscribe button. Fill out the required information and smash the submit button. And you'll be kept up to date as soon as I publish new content. Please have fun.
Hey, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name still remains your boy Papi. If today's your first time being on my YouTube channel, please subscribe to receive more content like this. And don't forget to smash on the bell so you can receive notification whenever I drop a new video. I also appreciate if you hit on the like button. Last but not the least, don't forget to drop your comment because it matters to me a lot. I'll be right back.
In today's hectic society, the opportunity to conduct things online is invaluable. It is possible to open a bank account online in a matter of minutes. It may only take a few minutes and save you a trip to the bank. And it may be your only option if you're opening an account with an online bank. Fortunately, most banking chores may be completed online. Everything is done digitally, and once your account is established, you may move funds and pay bills online. In today's video, I'll show you how to open a bank account from the comfort of your own home without having to go to the office. Please be sure you watch this video tutorial all the way through without stopping to gain a better understanding. Now let's set the ball rolling. We're going to create bank account using Standard Chartered Bank. You can use their official website or their mobile app to complete the registration. I'm going to use the mobile app. Go to Play Store or Apple Store, then download SC Mobile Gunna app. After successfully downloading, go ahead and open the app. Right on the app interface, you click on Get Started. There comes a pop-up. We're going to select the right option since we're new to their platform. It will take few seconds to load the page and it take me right to the page where I select the account type. There are three major types of bank accounts that are available at Standard Chartered. 1. Current account. This sort of bank account is perfect for persons who require a bank account for their salary and daily transactions. You can apply for a loan and other credit offers with this sort of bank account, which also includes a checkbook and free credit card for your online transactions. 2. Savings account. Besides a current account, a savings account pays interest and has a limit on the number of transactions that can be done per month. There are no monthly fees with this sort of account, and you may opt for daily, weekly, or monthly statements to be sent to your email. Finally, fixed deposits. If you really are interested in investing, this is the ideal type of account for you. With this account, you may make the most of every cedis you earn while also growing your savings. It also offers competitive interest rates, which are updated daily and paid monthly. There are various categories offered under each type of account for you to pick from. So in this tutorial, I'm going to select e-youth account, which is under current account. I think this was purposely designed for the youth and students. I'll click apply to begin the application. But first, let's go over the requirements for completing the account registration. You will need an original copy of your national ID, which is now known as a Ghana card, as well as a valid passport or driver's license. After you have ensured that you have these documents, you must understand that you must be 18 years of age or older to apply for this account. Let's go ahead and start the application. It is critical that you give accurate information if you want this application to be completed successfully. They need your basic information on this page, and the first question asks how you want them to address you. As a result, you submit your full legal name. You will then be required to submit both your phone number and your WhatsApp number, as they will video call you on WhatsApp to activate your account. Finally, input your email address and confirm that it is a valid and functional email account before clicking the next arrow to proceed to the next page. Now it's time to validate our phone numbers, so they've sent a 6-digit code to my phone number, which I'll enter and then submit. After completing the phone verification, I'm prompted to enter my nationality information, so I'll choose Ghana because I'm Ghanaian. Now it's time to verify I'm a Ghanaian. You'll need any of the documents listed below to confirm your identity. Here you can choose National ID, which serve as your Ghana card, and click the next arrow to proceed to the next page. Finally, we arrive at the photo taking page, where you must snap a selfie of yourself as well as a photo of your ID card. You can see my driver's license there because I selected it to prove my identity. So click on the plus sign to proceed with the selfie. There are instructions while taking the selfie, so pay attention to them to get the best results. It will automatically upload to their system, and you will then select the second option, which requires you to take a photo of your ID from both the front and back. It's very important you provide your own ID card if you want this application to be successful. I can't show you this section because of security concerns, but when you've completed the ID capture and it has finished uploading, click the Save button. We can now proceed to the next page, where you must double-check the scanned information. So go ahead, edit and rectify any errors you find. They want additional information about you as they move on to the next page. You fill out all of the required details, including your birthplace and mother's name, before clicking the next arrow to proceed to the next page. On this new page, you talk more about your employment status, your source of income, your monthly salary, and many more. Let's continue the tutorial by clicking the next arrow to proceed to the next page. My address information is needed here. For sake of this tutorial, I will go to Google and search for fake Ghana address. I will do more of copy and paste till I have filled out the information needed, but I will advise you to provide correct address details if you have them. Finally, we have arrived at the exciting part of this video. We will receive a free Visa debit card once our account is successfully created. You begin by inputting the referral code, which I recommend you enter mine if you appreciate my efforts in producing this video. You can find my code on your screens. Once you're done, you can scroll down to select the purpose of wanting to create bank account with them. I selected general or personal transactions. Now they will like to understand how we intend to use the account, which includes total deposits and withdrawals per month. We almost done with the application. They want my tax information, which was previously known as TIN number, but currently we use Ghana card as our everything, so go ahead and enter your Ghana card number. Finally, we have arrived at the final stage, which is to upload a utility bill or any other document displaying your address, so you can take a photo of your Ghana card. We also need to provide a photo of your signature, so get a piece of paper and sign it. Before you upload the photo, double check that it is legible. When you're finished, click the next arrow button. We are through with the forms. All that remains is to examine all of the information we gave, agree to the terms and conditions, and click the next arrow button when finished. We must wait 2 business days for a response from the bank. They will also video call you on WhatsApp to validate your identification and activate your account, as well as assist you in correcting any errors you made when filling out the documents. So, after more than 2 days of waiting patiently, I had a video call from their staff and completed all of the necessary processes. Then I receive activation login information, which includes a temporary user ID and password. Let's continue so I can teach you how to activate your account using this temporary user ID and password. Right from the login page, you'll find a button to enter those temporary login details. We'll go with the second option, which says register with temporary login details. Click the tiny box to indicate that you have agreed to the terms and conditions. Now input the temporary ID you got via email and the password you got via SMS. On the following screen, we allowed to generate a new login details, which includes your new user ID and password. Congratulations, we have successfully registered for Standard Chartered Online Banking. Creating an account is simple if you follow the steps in this video guide. I can now log in using my new username and password. A 6-digit code has been issued to my phone number, which I will enter to log in. We're in now, so click the Remind Me Later button to return to your dashboard. Our account is fully ready for use. I waited for 15 days, then I received a call saying I should come to post office to pick up my Visa debit card. On my next video, I will teach you guys how to activate the debit card, so watch out. I hope by the end of watching this video you have been able to create your own bank account, as I've tried my best to cover all that's necessary. Nevertheless, you can drop a comment via comment box below if you encountered any glitch while creating your account, and I will try my best and reach out to you as soon as possible. See you on my next video.
Yeah. Everybody knows that I'm breaking down. Everybody knows I ain't faking now. Everybody knows my heart's faking now. Yeah, she hates me now. I made mistakes, but now I don't ever wanna be alone. I don't really ever feel at home. On my own, in the zone. That's the only way I know. Feeling low, about to blow back up. Here I go. Never let the doubt.